the wonders of walking in love. It is crucial that we emphasize these words coming from God this particular season, because it looks as if the church has become a war zone. It looks as if the church has forgotten the primary reason why it existed. It looks as if the church has forgotten why, what God has in mind when it was established. And gradually, we see the glory of God distance herself from the church. We see the power of God distance herself from the church. And people wonder, something is missing. Something is missing. And until it's recovered, the church cannot be the same again. Until it's recovered, the church cannot be the same again. And we believe God that the death of Jesus Christ on the cross will not be in vain. And so this is a generation that will not fail God. This is the generation that will not fail God. Whatever that was missing, indeed, Lord, in my time, it will be recovered. The glory of God will be recovered. Am I talking to somebody here? This is that we can't fail God. We can't fail God. We have so much sick miracles that we've forgotten why we existed. We have clamored for signs and wonders. That the adventure for seeking signs and wonders has made us heartless. People clamoring for signs, wonders. People going to church seeking for deliverance. It has left believers heartless. So Christianity has become a survival of the fittest. Only the fittest survived. It was not so in the beginning. It was not so in the beginning. And this will keep quiet. This will degenerate. This will degenerate. Carrying a big Bible yet with too much bitterness and competition in your heart. No wonder we have become so powerless. No wonder we have become so voiceless. The church that was once in power has lost that glory. The church that was once in authority has lost that. We gather pretending to love one another, but no. All lover in the body of Christ is an illusion. 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 People looking after themselves, people existing for themselves, people sitting down in church only for themselves. Please hear this. Walking in love makes you more spiritual than days and long hours of fasting and prayers. You are not spiritual until you can show love, give love, act in love. You are not spiritual until you can show love, give love, and everything you do in the house of God, let it be love motivating. You are not spiritual because you fasted for 21 days. You are spiritual because you know how to walk in love. How to walk in love. Don't tell me you don't care about your brothers and sisters in church. Walk in love. Ephesians chapter number 5, verse 1 and 2. Hallelujah. Be ye therefore followers of God as their children. This is the intention. This is what God has in mind. The intention was not for you to go to church. God's intention was for you to be a follower of Christ. The agenda is not to be a church goer. The agenda was to be a follower of Christ. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Church was never God's agenda. Hello somebody. Church was never church gathering was never God's agenda. The agenda was Christ came to the daughters of God. He came to reconcile children to the Father. He came as a mediator. He came as to establish and bridge the gap between sons and their father. It was not church he had in mind. It was not church. So it's not my church. Your church. I am better. I am more anointed. That is not what God had. What we have in this generation is the perversion of the original truth. Perversion of God's vision and idea. Everywhere. So Christianity has become a laughing stock. A laughing matter. People laugh at us. Scorn at us. Because they are before their very eyes, they say, believer, butcher themselves. See, believer betray themselves. He said, be a follower. The intention was not for you to attend church. The intention was not for you to become a church member. The intention was to be a follower of Christ. And if you're a follower of God, it means you are a child of God or children of God. And if you are children of God, there's something that is required of you. And walk in love. And walk in love as Christ also had loved us. If you want to sit down and analyze this scripture, you will weep. You will weep. He said, as children of God, you are expected to walk in love. And walking in love, this is the example set for you to. He said, this is how you should walk in love. He said, okay, if you're going to walk in love, how to walk in love? He said, look at how Christ lived his life. He said, that's how you should walk in love. He said, how did he? He said, he loved you even when he didn't know you. Yeah.